Hello, chemistry crew. It's Kara Lenorovitz, and welcome back to our 11th week of segment two. As those numbers are ticking up there, that means we are getting closer and closer to the finish line. So hang in there. We have some great work yet to do and some good learning ahead, but you are getting closer to finishing this course. So I know that you're feeling like you've been on a long race, and you have been, but we're almost there. All right, couple of things for this week. Mostly the same things that we've been thinking about. Again, make sure you're using that weekly learning plan. There are some additional resources embedded in this week that are going to be really helpful to you. So make sure you're taking a glance at that. We are going to be having class together this Thursday, April 8th. Thank you for your flexibility with the change of last week. That was partially in response to a change in my schedule and also response to where all of you are in terms of making progress in class. So hopefully you use that time well. We will be back together again this Thursday to do a little critical thinking about the work that you've done around equilibrium and adding in a little bit more around Le Chatelier's principle, which you're going to explore this week. Office hours. There is one change this week. I am in the fortunate position of going to get my second COVID vaccine shot, and in anticipation of maybe not feeling so great on Tuesday, I will not be available for office hours this coming Tuesday. I will be available for office hours on Wednesday. So if you know you would like to meet, please go ahead and reserve a time on Wednesday, and I'd be more than happy to give you some assistance. I will be doing my best to respond to emails as I can, but just know my availability on Tuesday will be a little limited. Also, upcoming, the end of course is soon. We are wrapping up Module 7 in terms of new content this week. You will be wrapping up your DBA and Module 7 exam in the following week. And make sure that you're hanging in there because we only have one more module to go. I also want to let you know that in this last week, as promised, I have gone back through, and I know this is consistent with your other VT/VLC courses as well. If you have work that is more than 2 weeks past due, it has been replaced with a zero. In part, the goal behind that is to give you a more realistic view of your standing in class and your progress in class. But please, please keep in mind that those zeros are not permanent. If you have something right now that's in the gradebook as a zero, that means go back and give that attention and finish it up and turn it in. And as you do, I will do my best to grade it, give you feedback, and incorporate that into your grade. If you need help, if you know you're behind, please do reach out so that I can help you map out a plan to get yourself caught back up and be on target. My strongest recommendation, if you are in that position, is to keep yourself current with our current work and then in parallel work on catching up. The last thing here, we are definitely at the precipice of this right now, which is April break. Mine will happen from April 17th to April 25th, which means there's one more week after this week that I will be available. Just like over February vacation, when you're on your February vacation, I was as well. For April vacation, when it's my break, I will not be regularly checking email and I won't be having office hours. You will receive a new weekly learning plan on April 12th. I will be available for office hours during that week. We will not have a synchronous session. And if you are in class that week, you're going to work on your chemistry work that week. If you are on break that week, you're going to take break. The flip will happen in that second week. I will be on vacation that second week. Several of you will be back in class that second week, so you will take your chemistry work and do it during that second week. As always, because you are learning remotely, if you want to stretch your work over that two-week period of time, you may. We'll touch base about it a little bit further when we have class this week. As well, one of the things that's coming up is your discussion-based assessment for Module 7. We're going to run that a little bit differently because of the timing of April break. So know that there's some news coming your way about that, and I will share that news with you during class on Thursday. So let's take a look at the weekly learning plan and what you're going to be doing this week. You have one new concept that you're going to be focusing on here, and I apologize in advance. I have Spanish as a background, not French, but you're going to be learning about Le Chatelier's principle. It has to do with taking an chemical reaction that is at equilibrium, so forward rate and reverse rate are happening at the same rates, and you're going to see what happens when you apply stresses to that system that was otherwise in equilibrium. You're going to play around with what happens if you change, so increase or decrease, the concentration or availability of a reactant or product. You're going to explore what happens if the reactant and products happen to be gases. If you increase or decrease the pressure, what happens to the forward and reverse reaction of rates of that reaction? And you're going to play around with changing temperature. One of the things I want to emphasize here is that when you're thinking about temperature, it's very, very helpful to rewrite a chemical equation showing energy either as a product, which is the case in an exothermic reaction with a negative enthalpy, or as a reactant, as it's shown here in an endothermic reaction. So know that as you're playing around with concentration, pressure, and temperature, writing a model for yourself of that chemical equation in the unstressed and the stressed stages can be really helpful in terms of conceptually understanding what's going on, and then making your prediction as to whether a chemical reaction is going to shift to the right, which means make more product, or shift to the left, which means make more reactant. Do give yourself some time to play around with this concept, and I strongly encourage you to check out some of the additional videos. As well, your second job this week is going to be the last stage of your collaboration project. At this point, you should have posted an initial post about your topic, whether it was about food chemistry or biochemistry or pharmaceuticals or chemical engineering or health and beauty or environmental chemistry. You now hopefully have responded to somebody else's post, and you're into the third phase where you're going to be writing your reflection. I will emphasize this again, but what you will be turning in for this product is the part one, part two, and part three all in one document. So though you've done your posting on our discussion board, you'll want to make sure you have a representation of each part one, two, and three in the same document when you turn that final piece in. Third job, of course, is to attend class this week. So we'll take a quick glance at the weekly learning plan. As usual, weekly learning plan starts out with an analogy for you, this case about stress, and gives you some context for our learning this week. You're going to see the new learning objectives. Again, there are only two new ones that are coming in as new content. Do give yourself some time because you're going to be making lots of connections with your prior learning here. Reminders about communication and pacing, and then your to-do list. Again, three jobs here. One is to explore Le Chatelier's principle. Again, here I've given you several additional resources. I found that for me, these were very helpful to see more than one perspective on this content, so I encourage you to check that out. I also encourage you to check out at least one of the two last videos here to give you a little more depth of understanding of the Haber-Bosch process. In your reading, in your lesson, it is kind of presented in a glowing and positive light, and absolutely there are some wonderful things that have come out of that particular reaction. However, there is a dark side to that as well. The nitrogen that is fixed can both be used as a fertilizer, which can be helpful for producing food, but it also causes a lot of nitrogen pollution, which causes a lot of environmental issues. And that same fixed nitrogen is also used in explosives. So please bear in mind that you're seeing just one perspective in the lesson. Those last two videos will give you a little bit more of an angle on some of the other parts of the Haber-Bosch process. Second job is to complete the segment two collaboration project. Again, you should have part one and part two done already. You're going to be finishing part three. Again, you want to make sure you're turning all three parts in one document so that when I get a chance to look at your work, I can see all of your thinking all the way through in one simple click. And lastly, you're going to attend class on Thursday. Please make sure you're bringing any questions with you. All right, so again, here are your three jobs. You're going to be completing 7.07. Again, do watch some of those additional videos. You're going to complete your collaboration project, parts one, two, and three. Make sure you're turning in one document with all of those pieces included. And then, yes, we will have a synchronous session this week on Thursday. Please bring your questions with you. If you do need help, if you have questions before then, please reach out. I look forward to seeing you during office hours and seeing all of you on Thursday this week. Take care.